नर्सरी स्कूल बच्चों के लिए बाल 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 भारती करके वो ला रहे हैं, तो उसकी कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द बिल्डिंग में हम हमारा ट्रस्ट विल बी देयर टू फंड द बिल्डिंग।
कि आपने शादी क्यों नहीं की?
ऐसा कोई इसमें कोई रीजन, कोई
आपके मामा जी ने भी नहीं की थी?
हाँ जी,
तो
हाँ, अगेन माय मामा जी ने इसलिए नहीं किया बिकॉज ही वॉज वेरी बिजी विथ हिज वर्क, ही वॉज वर्किंग फॉर बिल्डर्स, यूज टू ट्रेवल अब्रॉड वेरी फ्रिक्वेंटली दोज डेज एंड ऑल, ही वॉज वेरी बिजी विथ हिज वर्क एंड ऑल, एंड देन ही हैड अ बिग सोशल लाइफ एंड ही वॉज डूइंग लॉट ऑफ सोशल वर्क एंड ऑल, आई थिंक दैट kept him very very busy and all।
जहां आज का जमाना बेहद मतलबी और खुदगर्ज लोगों का है, उन लोगों के बीच में कुछ ऐसी शख्सियत मौजूद हैं जो अपनों के लिए अपना पूरा जीवन डेडिकेट कर देते हैं, और आज स्टूडियो में मेरे साथ ऐसी ही शख्सियत मौजूद हैं, मिस्टर सुधीर माथुर सर। सर, आपका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है।
थैंक यू सो मच।
मैं आपको बता दूं कि सुधीर माथुर वो शख्सियत हैं जिन्होंने अपना पूरा जीवन अपनी बहन और अपने मामा जी के लिए डेडिकेट कर दिया। उनकी लेगेसी को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए वो हर दिन कुछ नया करते हैं, जिससे इनके जाने के बाद भी उन्होंने इनको जिंदा रखा हुआ है। सर, मैं आपसे जानना चाहूँगी कि जिस तरह से आप जयपुर की जानी मानी शख्सियत में से एक हैं, आज आपने अपने अपनों के लिए, अपने मामा जी के लिए, अपनी बहन के लिए इतना सब कुछ किया है, आपको इसकी इंस्पिरेशन कहाँ से मिली?
मैं आपको बताऊं, राइट फ्रॉम द बिगनिंग माय चाइल्डहुड वाज नॉट वेरी हैप्पी बिकॉज आई लॉस्ट माय फादर एट द एज ऑफ 8 एंड देन माय मदर व्हेन आई हैड जस्ट एंटर्ड कॉलेज। सो यू नो माय स्ट्रगल, देयर वाज लॉट ऑफ स्ट्रगल इन माय लाइफ एंड माय जर्नी, चाइल्डहुड जर्नी एंड लेटर ऑल्सो वॉज फुल ऑफ स्ट्रगल एंड इट वॉज आई बट ऑफकोर्स आई केम ओवर all that struggles and all in a very good way, and I learnt a lot from there. And of course after I lost my parents, that my mama, my uncle, he was my savior, he was my mentor, he was my guardian, he was more than a father to me. So me and my younger sister, we stayed all our lives with him, and we learnt a lot from him, and he was a person who lived his life for others. So we saw him very closely, and what we saw him operating, how he used to operate and how he used to just give with open hands, and he used to always say that the left hand should not know what your right hand is giving. So you know, all those things right from childhood I picked up from him, and so did my sister, but unfortunately I lost her 19 years back. And since then, I wanted to keep my uncle and my sister alive. So I'm running a trust also in their name. It's called Raghusinha Mala Mathur Charity Trust, and out of which we are doing lot of social work, and I'm associated with lot of associations and NGOs and all. And what I feel is that whenever we do any activity, whenever we do any work for a social cause, their name comes up because of the trust name and all, and that is the time that everyone talks about them, and I feel that is the right way, and that is my way of remembering them, keeping them alive. And of course there are so many people that who get inspired by all the work the trust is doing, the work I am doing. I do it from my heart, I do it with my own hands, and the kind of satisfaction I get, it is just tremendous, and I feel very good doing it. And to tell you is that on 5th of May my uncle had completed 100 years. And for him I wanted a book to come up, and something I want, it was my dream project that before I leave this world, that there should be something in black and white which is kept in every house for people to, for the coming generation to get inspired. So we invited, he did not leave any written documents about himself and the kind of work he was doing, but you know, then we आई थॉट दैट सिंस इट्स टू लेट एंड ऑल हिज फ्रेंड्स आर ऑल्सो गोइंग बाय सो आई इन्वाइटेड अराउंड अबाउट 68 people, family and his very close friends to give us a write-up on him. And so now what I've done is that I've compiled those articles with photographs, with memories, fond memories of everyone in a book form. And I've called it Raghu Sinha, His Life and Legacy.
जी, तो आपके मामा जी रघु सिन्हा जी के बारे में मैं बहुत कुछ सुन चुकी हूँ और अभी भी जैसा कि आपने बताया ऐसा मैंने सुना है कि उन्हें अनक्राउंड प्रिंस भी कहा जाता था तो ये टाइटल उनको कैसे मिला?
Yes, ma'am, I'll tell you is that of course he was called Uncrowned Maharaja of Jaipur and how this came up was that you know so many years back when I was in school way back in 70s or late 60s and all so that time whoever used to come from places abroad and all and they used to come and visit Jaipur so first thing they used to do is that they used to go to city palace and meet our maharaja brigadier bhavani singh ji of Jaipur so they used to go and have a evening with him and then later of course he they would have heard of my uncle from their friends abroad and they used to say that if you're going to Jaipur you must meet our friend Mr. Raghu Sinha so they used to get in touch with my uncle and then my uncle my mama he used to call them over at his place give them wine and dinner and take them shopping and all those kind of things and what hospitality and all he used to extend so they used to go back to their countries and they used to write letters from them thanking him and they used to say that we came to Jaipur we met two maharajas one the crowned maharaja and the other one uncrowned maharaja and you are really the uncrowned maharaja of Jaipur who is doing so much for everyone and everyone has so much of respect for you
जैसा कि हमारे भारत में ये प्रचलित है कि अतिथि देवो भव
yes.
उसको अच्छे से जो चरितार्थ किया है वो रघु सिन्हा जी ने किया है इसलिए उनको ये टाइटल मिला इसी के साथ साथ सर मैं आपके बारे में भी जानना चाहूंगी कि आपने शादी क्यों नहीं की
ऐसा कोई इसमें कोई रीजन कोई
आपके मामा जी ने भी नहीं की थी
हाँ जी
तो
हाँ अगेन माय मामा जी ने इसलिए नहीं किया बिकॉज ही वाज वेरी बिजी विथ हिज वर्क ही वाज वर्किंग फॉर बिल्डर्स यूज्ड टू ट्रैवल अब्रॉड वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली दोज डेज एंड ऑल ही वाज वेरी बिजी विथ हिज वर्क एंड ऑल एंड देन ही हैड अ बिग सोशल लाइफ एंड ही वाज डूइंग लॉट ऑफ सोशल वर्क एंड ऑल आई थिंक दैट केप्ट हिम वेरी वेरी बिजी एंड ऑल मे बी बिकॉज एंड ऑल्सो टू टेल यू इज दैट यू नो ही ब्रॉट अप 10 चिल्ड्रन हाउ 10 चिल्ड्रन His two sisters, one of the sisters, my mother, and the other one, my mossy. Both of them lost their husbands at an early age and they were left with five children each. So, and those children, my mama, Raghu Sinha Saab, he only brought us up. So, he was a mentor, he was a guardian, he was a father, he was a parent to 10 children. Can you imagine? And So probably I think that kept him away from getting married because he used to always say agar meri shaadi ho jaati to I wouldn't have been able to bring up these children. So I think that was one reason for him not getting married and plus of course he was very busy. My reason was that you know when you lose your parents at an early age and all in every household what I feel is that when the parents are there they ensure their children get married they go to a good family the girls especially and all and get a nice girl for the house all those kind of things probably in my case everyone was there but probably that was missing so that part and also you know my sister who I lost as I was telling you 19 years back for cancer Mala she was doing extremely well she was regional sales manager for Jet Airways in Rai Science she nice. She set up offices in Jaipur Jodhpur and Udaipur and so you know we wanted me and my uncle wanted her to get married and settle down because she was a girl and so I was very keen though she was 3 years younger to me But I was, whoever used to tell me, why don't you get married? I said, nee, I'm waiting for Mala to get married, then there's no hurry, I'll get married. No, you should get married, that Bhabhi will come and she'll find a boy for her, all those kind of things. But you know, that time just went on and all, and then suddenly she was diagnosed of cancer, and then I got busy with her illness, and I was there all the time, and we used to go to Bombay to take the treatment. So I was throughout with her for the treatment, and then also I was doing my job with my company ITC, and usme bhi, of course, I was very, very busy, but it was very nice of the organization of my company to give me all the time, free time, to be with my mother, with my sister, and take care of her during her illness.
मामा जी के साथ साथ आप खुद एक इंस्पिरेशन हैं हमारे समाज के लिए. ऐसा बहुत कम लोगों में देखने को मिलता है कि आप अपने जीवन को अपने प्यारे लोगों के लिए आप समर्पित कर देते हैं. और इतना ही नहीं, आपने अपने चाहने वालों को आज तक जिंदा रखने के लिए वो तमाम सारे काम किए हैं कि जब आप भी 100 साल पूरे करेंगे उसके बाद आप भी याद किए जाएंगे. सर, आपने जो ये बुक लॉन्च की है अपने मामा जी के नाम पे, मैं हमारे व्यूअर्स को भी दिखाना चाहूँगी. ये बुक है जो इन्होंने अपने मामा जी के नाम पे लॉन्च की है, इसमें वो सारी बातें इन्होंने लिखी हैं जो इन्होंने पूरे जीवन में इनके साथ बिताया है, देखा है, सुना है. इसी के साथ साथ सर, मैं ये भी जानना चाहूँगी कि जिस तरह से अभी आपने बताया है कि आपके मामा जी ने 10 बच्चों का पालन पोषण किया, इस तरीके से आप भी चैरिटीज़ करते हैं, हॉस्टल्स में, जैसे बालिका हॉस्टल्स जो होते हैं उनको भी आप डोनेट करते हैं, तो क्या आप आगे के मोटिवेशन के लिए और क्या क्या कर रहे हैं समाज के लिए, और क्या क्या कर रहे हैं?
इसी लाइन में हम लोग काफ़ी चीज़ें कर रहे हैं. एनी न्यू प्रोजेक्ट विच कम्स अप, जैसे मैं आपको बताऊं, विद्या आश्रम का नाउ इसी कैंपस में जयपुर में दे आर कमिंग अप विद अ नर्सरी स्कूल बच्चों के लिए, बाल भारती करके वो ला रहे हैं. तो उसकी कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द बिल्डिंग में हमारा ट्रस्ट विल बी देयर टू फंड द building, and then later, of course, we are not very equipped to run these kind of organizations, these buildings and all. There are many other very nice people who are associated with the school and with the building and all. They will do their work, but of course we will be there in the committee, and we will see to it that our name, our trust name, and our my uncle's name, my sister's name is well preserved there. And whatever I feel is that, you know, after me, those values, the all those things will go with me probably. So, you know, I have less time, so in that time I want to do a lot of things and leave it behind for coming generations to enjoy and to cherish whatever memories they have of me, of the family, and also to keep up the family legacy and the family name, because I feel the family name means a lot to the society. Like today we talk about Durlabji, so we have this hospital in mind when we talk about Durlabji hospital and Durlabji family. So they are doing such good work, and likewise there are many other organizations they are doing, and their name. So I want my name to be my uncle's name, my sister's name, that to be remembered. And to tell you that usme jab unka naam log aadar se samman se lenge aur yaad karenge to wo puri family, so I will always be there. So this is my objective and this is my dream project. Like even this book you're talking about, it was my dream project that before I go away, that I wanted that something in writing should be there about my uncle, about my sister, what all they did for the society. And also, so we have 68 articles in this, and all his close friends and family have come up with these articles with great memories and incidents and everything about them, with lovely photographs and all. So it's this was my dream project. And also I feel that this book is going to be very, very inspiring So we are going to put this copy of the book in school libraries, and also any competition held in any school, we would want to give this as a token of appreciation.
तो आपने साउथ की मूवी में फैमिली स्टार तो देखा होगा, लेकिन ही इज द रियल फैमिली स्टार ऑफ आवर सोसाइटी.
मैं उम्मीद
करती हूँ सर कि आपकी जो इंस्पिरेशन स्टोरी है जो आपने इस बुक के जरिए बताने की कोशिश की है, मैं उम्मीद करती हूँ हमारे दर्शकों तक ये पहुँचेगी. उन्हें भी समाज में फैमिली के वैल्यूज पता होने चाहिए. आगे जो हमारी संस्कृति है उसको आगे ले जाने में बहुत ही ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट रोल प्ले करती है. बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया सर हमसे जुड़ने के लिए.
थैंक यू सो मच.
तो कैसे लगी आपको ये इंस्पिरेशन स्टोरी, बताइएगा जरूर. और इस बुक को पढ़ना ना भूलिएगा, बहुत ही जल्दी आप तक पहुंचने वाली है. और ऐसे ही वीडियोस के लिए देखते रहिए. नमस्कार.